Congratulations, Nabi. We are at the doorstep of our martyrdom.
Praise Allah.
Praise Him. Soon we will be greeted by Allah, the one true God, and by the cheers of our forefathers. And by 99 perfect virgins who will worship us for all eternity.
I thought it was 100.
What's that?
100 virgins. They promised me 100.
99, 100. What's the difference?
If they're telling you one thing and they're telling me another, maybe they don't know for sure.
Maybe. Maybe the exact number of virgins is not precise.
I mean, if it's in the 90s, I can live with that.
Or 75.
Hey, I'm not greedy, but what if it's 10?
Well,
what if it's 10, but we have to split them between us?
Then you'll have 5 more virgins than you have right now,
right?
We're talking about eternity here. How long will 5 virgins last you?
Maybe a month? They're not going to be virgins for long, right?
Look, would it make you feel better if we called the big guy?
Yes.
Take this thing. Osama, yes, it's us. No, we're on it. It's fine, but security takes forever, you know. What are you going to do? Anyway, look, Nabi has a question. Will you talk to him?
No. Talk to him.
Hello. Yes.
It's about the virgins.
Really?
It was 100 when I signed up.
There's not that many anymore. Too many martyrs than the first to go around.
You've got to be kidding me. Does he know where we are here? Give me the phone, please. Take this thing. Osama, Sasif, right now, can you tell me the number absolutely that you can guarantee Nabi and myself as far as virgins are concerned? No, that's fine. I can't guarantee more than 20. Screw this, right?
I'm glad you said it first.
Okay, get on the intercom, tell the passengers we are changing course for the Bahamas.
Bahamas!
And a long weekend.
The standoff with Mr. Cruz has now stretched into its 8th day. Cruz continues to insist that police are violating his parental and religious freedoms, citing human sacrifice as essential.
Today on Good Morning Paradise, mayoral candidate Eugene Wells joins us to talk about the new political landscape and the newest toy craze of the year, Grouchy Dolls. Stay tuned, it's going to be a super dupe show.
Turn down that fucking TV! I can't hear my show.
Yeah, nothing's good on anyway.
Just, preparing for my interview.
Fight! Oh, you fight like a pussy. No one's gonna hire your sorry ass. Why don't you go stick up to your Uncle Dave already?
God damn it!
What the hell is going on out there?
Nothing.
Make sure you get that welfare check.
Kiss, kiss, sweetie pie.
Come on! Come on! No. Bad boy. Bad boy. I told you, no poopies in our yard. No poopies in this yard. You only poop in the next door neighbor's yard.
Feces in the yard. It's a violation of trailer park ordinance number 101-40.
Stop eating the poop.
I'll add that to the list.
The list? The list. Great, the list. What else? What else you got on the list?
Ordinance number 143-11. Yesterday around lunchtime. Now, I don't care what you two do in your own bedroom, but ordinance number 143-11 says if I hear you lewd lovemaking after 10 a.m., I get to file a grievance against the sorry ass, which is exactly what I'm gonna do.
Okay. Well, at least I wasn't boning my sister, you inbred hick. Oh, for your information, hillbilly, I wasn't even here yesterday afternoon. I hate this town. This fucking sucks.
And NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, does not exist. All the space missions that we've heard about since we were little kids in school, creations of Hollywood. We did not land on the moon. There is no John Glenn. Well, there's a John Glenn who's a senator.
Hey, hello, you, professor. What is this, reading library?
Yeah, 2 minutes, buddy.
Not 2 minutes now. You buy now or bye-bye?
Buddy, num-num.
Go on, bye-bye. Go on,
bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, goodbye. Don't let the door hit you on that way out.
Daddy, Muhammad says he needs to talk to you again.
What about?
What else? Okay, so what did she say about me exactly? That slut.
Killer, yeah, run till I die. Boy, I get 47 from side to side.
Jihad killer.
Yes, I'm here. You just hope to stay bad out of this atmosphere.
Jihad killer.
Yeah,
my brother. Any police come around today? Anything suspicious?
No, man, trust me. You are simply hidden here for as long as you want.
Well, that may not be for much longer. We have news from Afghanistan.
News?
It is all coming together. The shipment left 3 days ago.
Oh. Praise Allah. When will it be?
Tomorrow! The time has come for us to place our swords to the genitals of the infidels.
Woohoo!
I see you notice the hands. Motivational. Those are every fucking bastard that I had to climb over to get this job.
Jesus.
Pal, they're paper mache. He thought they were real. Sit down. Let's get started. So, I hope you don't mind. I hope you don't mind the recording. We're gonna use it as training later. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, that's good.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
It's the chair is
actually. Alright, we're on a time clock, so let's get started, shall we?
Yes, sir.
Good.
Well, so I'm here for the job, sir.
Right. You're a factory worker.
I was a factory worker, but the factory got closed down, so I got laid off, and
I've interviewed 15 other people for this job. What makes you think you're better than them?
Well, I don't know if I am better than them.
Well, goddamn it, pal. If you want this job, you better reach out and grab it. You better put those fucking heads on the wall. You know what? Fuck it. Let's go to the questions.
What is your greatest strength?
I'm a really good team player.
Wrong. What is your biggest weakness?
I'd say I work too hard.
Wrong. How would you move a mountain using only a spoon?
A spoon?
If you were in a box, how would you think outside it?
If you're in...
Wrong. Last question. What is the difference between a duck?
People. A duck? I don't... Yeah, I came here for a job. A job!
As far as I know, that job has nothing to do with the cocksucking motherfucking duck.
Congratulations, pal. You're our leading candidate. How does it feel?
Feels good.
No. How does it feel? How does it feel? I mean, how does it feel to put fucking 15 heads on that wall? I'll tell you how it feels. It feels fucking great, doesn't it? Feel fucking great. Like,
So I got it. I got the job.
Oh, hell no. No. This was just like a getting to know you interview. Oh, yeah, no. We have a couple of more.
120?
Yeah, we have some more candidates to talk to. But hell of a start, though. Absolutely. Last thing before you go, I'd like you to sing the company fight song.
It's not a flag, it's a company, a high-flying company, and it'll cheerfully work you to death. By the time you are old, the pension is sold, and your cube will be your casket. It's a company, a high-flying company. Now please get back to work.
We'll get back to you.
I hate this town.
Change has begun. Spread the word today. Flower children, let them lead.
Brothers and sisters, I am proud to introduce to you the one. Hold up your energies for Uncle Dave!
Good group. Welcome to the denomination of organic monotheism. I congratulate you all on taking the first step to freedom by completing your training program. Obviously, you've come to the correct conclusion that the American dream is not a dream for you. In fact, it is a nightmare. A nightmare that soon will be engulfed in the all-encompassing flames of God's damnation! Yeah! Highest people in the house say, oh! Who loves God?
We do!
David?
Yeah, initiation. I love this.
No, Richie, this is just inner sanctum stuff, strictly ritualistic.
Uncle Dave, sorry to bother you, but we've got some rather important business. The girls, they need to go.
Okay, children, it appears that Brother Richard here has to commingle our energies. Sweetie,
let's go, come
sweetie.
On, please move.
There we go.
But I want more communion.
I will do communion, I promise. It's my favorite meal of the day. Don't worry about
That's
it.
That's nice.
Let's go.
I love that. Oh, hello. God. Bless it.
Richie, what the fuck is it? What's the problem?
We're having something of a cash flow problem.
What the fuck are you talking about, Richie? You see all those recruits out there today?
It's true. Membership and donations are at an all-time high, and we got more tail running around here than the Playboy Mansion, but it's...
Yeah? So, then what's the problem, Rich?
Well, it's the IRS.
Yeah? Well, what do they want?
It seems you haven't paid our taxes in 3 years.
So what, man?
I tried to explain, of course, that with our continued expectation of the end of the world, it's difficult to justify contributing to long-term programs like Medicare or Social Security. But, apparently even a selective tax payment is not an option.
Well, come on, Richie. You know I don't like to micromanage. What the fuck do we do about this, all right?
Well...
Huh? What's your plan?
We pay them. Or, oh! We pay them, or everything is all over. The weenie whacking, the pantless parties, the tacos, everything. And you? You go to jail.
So how much do we owe?
$1.3 million and 79 cents.
Oh, fuck, Rich.
Don't despair, Uncle Dave. When the government slams the door shut, G.O.D. always opens a window.
Wow. That's a beautifully retarded sentiment, Richie. Now, if you don't mind, I'd like to be alone.
Well, if you need me, I'm in the other room.
Seems pretty unlikely, Rich.
Unfortunately, the supply of crotchy dolls can't meet the demand, and parents and children alike have been lining up for weeks to get their hands on them. We'll be back in 2 minutes. See you then.
I prey on the innocent, living on the grind, trying to get a dollar out of 15 cents.
Standing hey, on yo, the corner, pal. Trying to steal paychecks. Come here, help me out with a few bucks.
I don't have any money.
Come on, I'm serious. Come over here. I need a few bucks to get a bus to go see my kids.
I don't have any money.
Hey, come here. I want to talk. Come here. Get the fuck out of here. I'm sick and tired of people like you, you know? You got a good job, you got a big car, you got everything and I got nothing. Well, fuck you and fuck everybody who even looks like you. Get the fuck out of here.
Brace yourself.
Fucking knock you out, pal.
Just to see how it feels.
It's green.
But you can make the light. Hey! You can make the light!
Come on, bitch!
God damn, she could have made the fucking light.
She forgot her glass.
You say glass?
Yes.
You say glass, you Frankfurt-eating motherfucker? I bought all these goddamn English CDs for you to say fucking glass? It's glasses! You fucking foreigners come over here and you fuck up the language, and this bitch is fucking up the traffic!
Come down, Greg.
You fucking calm down. This flat-ass bitch comes over here, she takes over the convenience stores, and they eat up all our goddamn dogs.
Go and help her. Come on.
You're right.
I'm tripping.
Let me just get the car and make sure she's doing okay. Huh? She's an old lady. Ugh. I feel bad now.
Hi. The light is green. The light is green. You could have went through the light. What'd you say, bitch?
What happened over there?
Thanks, call me nigger.
Whoa, ho, ho, did you see that?
Yeah.
One date with me, she'll look like she'd been hit with a mayonnaise truck.
That's right, Mr. Stickum. Yeah, I hope she comes back.
You got home. Thank you.
Okay.
All set?
Yes.
What do you got?
I will have a medium. No, you know what? I'm going to have a large. I'll have a large mocha.
Okay.
No. No. You know what? Maybe a vanilla.
Okay.
What do you think goes better with bagels?
You had 10 minutes to make up your fucking mind. What is it with you people? Can somebody please tell me? I mean, we sell coffee, that's it. Nothing else. You're not buying a car, I mean, right? Make a fucking decision, huh? How about it? I know. Here we go. You're gonna have a regular coffee. Careful, the beverage you're about to enjoy is extremely hot. Next.
What's the difference?
What?
I 2 lattes, no foam. Please.
Well.
believe this is the first time you've ever been here. I mean, all these fucking idiots calling me Uncle Dave, and here I am. Actually, I'm your Uncle Dave.
Yeah.
So, when was the last time I saw you?
The bachelor party. Right before the wedding night.
Oh, fuck yeah, right. That was fun. I wonder if that donkey survived. Well, what do you think of the place?
It's amazing.
Yeah, I kind of owe it all to you, you know.
Me?
Well, we always talked about running a con like this, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, about how gullible people are, how they'll believe anything if you just tell it to them a couple of times. Anyway, I just took all that talk, put it into action, pushed it to the next level, and here I fucking am.
Man, I just can't believe it, you know?
Yeah. You know, it's funny you showing up here like this. You know, because I find myself in a financial situation. I mean, I have a plan for getting out of it, but I could use a partner.
No. I know where this is going, Uncle Dave. I don't do that type of shit anymore.
Come on, it'd be like old times. Remember when we stole a flag from the governor's mansion?
Twice.
Yeah. And this plan, it's foolproof, man.
I got arrested the second time.
Well, that plan wasn't foolproof.
Yeah, they prosecuted me under the new Flag Protection Amendment, and with that on my record, I couldn't get into a good college or get a good job. I pretty much just played by the rules.
Look, man, nobody plays by the rules, all right? You bend them or you break them. Anything else is just slow death.
Yeah, that's what it feels like.
Man. All right, well, fuck it, man. I never push you to do anything, right? I always let you go your own way. Besides, it's working out great for you, right? I mean, you got the beautiful wife, the nice home. You change your mind, though, you let me know. Here, have a souvenir ashtray.
Thanks.
Now, you're going to get a welfare check for $168, right? You give me that check,
hey,
I'll give you $250 worth of food stamps. You understand what I'm saying? The major profit there. There's a good deal, pal. It's a fucking great deal.
That's $82.
$82? You're good at math. Hey, that's you. You're next. Here, use my pen. Use my pen. And don't forget to date it.
23-6.
Hey, have you heard that since the United States has closed their borders, they're getting rid of the Statue of Liberty?
I don't understand you.
All that scrap copper is going to be for sale.
I don't want copper. You go away.
Wrong form.
What?
Wrong form.
Look, I don't care what form I have, right? I'm not leaving here until I get my money.
Come on, people. Let's...
Where's his pen? Here's my pen. Hey, come here. He's got my pen.
Hey, I...
sweet, sweet cheeks.
Hey, neighbor. Guess I won't be needing that grievance after all, huh? Okay.
Gotta find the wet spot.
Leave the welfare check on the counter. Oh, yeah, there. Oh, yeah. Oh.
Please, Uncle Dave, please, just a few $100, just enough to get me out of this fuck old town for the rest of my life, please?
Hey, sports, last chance, come on, help me out with a few bucks.
I don't have anything.
Who the fuck do you think you're talking to, huh? What, do you think I'm stupid or something, huh? Listen, you're not gonna help me out. I'll help out myself. Open up the wallet.
Dude, who are you talking to?
No. Oh, my gun. What's the matter with you?
Bro, you still there? Hey, bro.
Yeah.
Hey, well, I got you. I gotta ask you, what do you think of those mileage rewards programs?
What's the matter with you? Let go!
No!
You know, I thought you could use those miles anytime to get tickets, right? But, you know, try it. You can't use them at Christmas.
Best chance.
No.
Give me the gun! No! Oh, shit, Smart.
It's like at every holiday, it's blacked out. Like, anytime you want to use the fucking things, it's blacked out.
I mean, that's bullshit, isn't it?
Dave?
Yeah?
I'm in.
You are? Oh, fuck, that's great, man.
Well, you know what? You caught me at kind of a busy time right now. So,
We, the people under Allah, give you a new beacon of strength against the great Satan of the West. They believe we are weakened, but in only a few days we will strike a blow against America so swift and terrible that the evil ones will collapse once and for all. We are asking those of the true faith to wait, pray, and praise Allah when the glorious slaughter begins.
And cut! Wonderful scene, Sammy. Just wonderful. You truly outdid yourself this time. You hold the screen. You are forceful, yet unbelievable. I almost cried in the middle there. You are such a star quality. You can't put it into words. You are a true superstar. Your voice, your eyes, they were popping.
What? Don't you know I'm lactose intolerant and you're trying to kill me? Who writes this shit? They're not listening anymore, Mohammed. I tell them about Allah and glory, and what do I get? What do I get every damn time?
Virgins.
Ding, 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 ding. Nobody wants to die anymore unless they get virgins.
But no one has to die this time. That is the genius of the shipment.
Oh, the shipment. Oh, big whoop. What is it this time, more anthrax?
Sammy. Why do you have to be like that? You remember the thing with the planes a few years back? Do you remember that? Do you remember that? Come on, do you remember that? Child's play! Tomorrow is when we really make our mark. You, me, and the shipment of crotchy dogs.
I'm gonna go watch Oprah.
She's looking good these days. The diet is working.
I'll do anything it takes to get the fuck out of paradise. Anything! Anything!
Okay. Take me up the ass. Just kidding. Nah, here. You know these things?
Cratchy does.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who has it? Biggest show on TV, number one. Oh, and the guy who does a voice for it? He's some big international star, right?
Doesn't matter, doesn't matter. All that matters is everybody wants one of those dolls, right? But, sadly, the Chinese tanker bringing them over here sank. They were able to save about 100,000 dolls. Unfortunately, none of the crew was rescued.
So what? There's not enough dolls?
Check this out, man. One of these dolls sold at auction this morning for $4,000.
Fuck me. And 2,000 times 4,000 dollars
is
eight.
That's like no, it's 800.
No,
eight,
well, it's eight.
You move.
And well, if it's three zeros and
you move the decimal back.
I don't think no. Well, wait. If you, it's a fucking lot of money.
Oh, it's an ass load of money,
dude. A couple of asses.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So what do you want out of me?
Come up with a plan. Because if you remember the whole flag stealing thing, that was my plan.
That sucked.
It has certain structural flaws.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. 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 What we gotta do is we gotta go to Little Germany.
Yeah.
And we gotta break in there, and we gotta get the dolls, and we gotta bring them back here.
So we're gonna need some sort of a
truck.
Truck would be good. One that can't trace back to us.
So right. Yeah.
You got an idea?
I got something. No, it's gone.
Oh.
George W. Bush is a sham. He's an actor. That's not even his real name.
He knows too much.
Mom, he's crazy. He suspects nothing. I'm sorry.
You are a good man, Habib. But we are at a critical point in the plan, and we must take no chances.
Goodbye, Heaven Tarts. Sugar logs, powdered flakes, and sweetie O's.
How much is this?
Thank you.
got my money, Harry. What you got for us today, Harry?
No, 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 no. Harry, come on. You've been out here for 2 hours and... donating. Help the retards. Do it $13, motherfucker. Let's go. What? Oh, okay. I thought you said something. You back talking to me? Fives and tens only. No bath this month, you son of a bitch.
I put some extra nutrients in your dinner. You're gonna like it. Let me see. Come on.
Good, isn't it? All right, baby. Well, good night. Big day tomorrow, okay?
All right.
What?
Oh, I'm tripping.
Sorry, buddy. It does get cold in my garage late at night.
All right.
Night, Harry.
Welcome to Little Germany Amusement Park, entertainment center for Paradise City. Now, tomorrow, the major media event will happen here at the stage, celebrating the unveiling of the Karachi Dolls, the huge international star of the Karachi Show will be there, and that is when we'll strike.
Oh.
Dave and I will be in the truck accessing the employee entrance.
You are a blessing upon us, my brother.
It is as it was foretold in the good book.
And then there will come one amongst them, an apostle who carries within him the holy torch of righteousness. He will lead us out of the clutches of consumerism. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You wrote a fucking Bible for these people?
Group C rappels down and takes the dolls from the storeroom. Group E must control the perimeter, as our intelligence indicates that another organization may be after the dolls as well.
I'll get that. Bin Laden, Lou, it's your dime.
Osama, you old fucker. It's GW.
You know how many innocent people we've had to torture trying to get a lead on you?
So it's not my fault. But what is it, Georgie? I'm kind of busy here.
You know how Pops has those oil pipelines in Saudi Arabia? I'm wondering if we ought to file an insurance claim. You know, after the whole thing blows up.
All right, well, drop me an email, tell me what pipe you're talking about, and I'll blow it all the way to Mecca.
We'd really appreciate it. I'll ask Laura to type that up. You know, me and spelling and all.
All right, later. Jihad!
First they promised me a private jet. Then they send me a frickin' bus. Jeez, don't they know I'm an international superstar? Ugh. Jesus! Oh, Jesus. Paradise. 8 miles. God! Motherfuckers.
I'm telling you, Mohammed, I know I've seen that gas station before. We're lost.
We are not lost. All gas stations look alike. What's wrong with you?
Will you just pull over and ask for directions?
Get off my back. You know, I'm doing my best here.
I should be driving.
What, do you think you're going to do everything? Be the face of the organization, also do the driving? What is wrong with you?
Hey,
here at the theme park, Little Germany, with owner and controversial director, Uwe Boll. Uwe, you made your fortune turning video games into hit movies, but this theme park has always been your passion, and today is a big day for Little Germany.
Absolutely. I'm totally happy that that freighter went down from China with all the crotchy dolls, so we are the only people in North America having the crotchy dolls exclusively here on sale.
Yay! All right, what is all this shit, man? Ooh, Harry, it's time to go to work. Put your hat on, let me see. Yeah! Watch this, watch this. Say we'll work for food in German. You the shit.
All right, go on now. All right, no ones. That's my motherfucker right there. Watch out for the flowers, Harry.
But I want to use that situation here where I'm live in TV, and I want to explain a little about the financing of my movies and also from Little Germany where the money comes from. Because, you know, there are all that rumors out that my movies are financed with Nazi gold, and what should I say? It's true. But somebody must do something with the money. I get a little horny here on stage sometimes. If you see the crowd and all their children.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Master, allow me.
What about me?
Your job.
Stupid. Oh, what, are you gonna fire me? For saying fuck? Well, fucky fuck fuck you, Dan. I'm the fucking show. You mind if I go to work now? Thank you.
I gotta shut my teeth.
Thank you. Hi, we're live at Little Germany in Paradise. It's an amazing sight. The crowd is trembling with excitement. People have been lining up for days to be the first to get their hands on the coveted crotchy dolls.
Ladies, today we do God's work. So get in there and give those boys a God job.
Oh, God.
They're so creepy.
They're so creepy.
Y'all, can you guys give me a hand?
Is that Fern's limo?
I can't see, Bob. There seems to be a pickup truck in the way.
A pickup truck? Well, that's classy.
Yeah, man. How unbelievably sorry we are, Mr. Treuer. I personally will take full responsibility for the confusion with the pickup.
I don't want you fired. I want your fucking boss fired.
So, what did you do with the guards?
They're all gone now.
All right, okay, ladies. Get to work. I looked in the crates. This is great. It means that the whole park is busy with the pissed off VIP. That means my plan is genius.
Cowboy up.
It's locked.
must be another way in.
Where's my money, housewife?
I have even better. Gold teeth.
Hello, paradise.
Well, you know what the good noble crotchet says about people in need.
Only my father and my priest can touch me there.
Look out!
What the fuck? Get to the truck. We'll meet you out front. Come on!
Hey, Frank, you better have some chaos out there. We're coming your way.
This is on Frank. Abort mission. You come down here. You'll be arrested in a second.
You are the envy of the entire country.
Give us the dolls. And Frank, we need a distraction. We need a distraction now!
You are the first city to receive the officially licensed Ratchy Doll.
Powerful Lord, hear my plea.
Ball, I'm Vince Desi. What the fuck you do to my game Postal?
I don't know what your fucking problem is. The movie's great.
Shit.
Officers, you realize there's a huge fight going on stage right now?
Yeah.
Hey, Frank, we're coming your way now.
Party's over. Freaking nasty, motherfucker. Get your hands
off. A video game. Oh! He shot Harry!
Son of a bitch!
Shop.
Lattes, no foam.
Yeah, I gotta go.
Why did you bring him?
Mind your own business and get us out of here!
Shut up,
you
sick tribe.
Wait! Hey!
Move.
You don't have the keys? I thought you had the keys.
Oh,
It's like when you were a kid. Sometimes it helps to retrace your steps.
Mohammed!
You're under arrest! You killed Harry! Start shooting, John! Do something! Shit! Harry wasn't hurting nobody! What the fuck am I gonna do with all those damn diamonds I bought him?
Oh, Allah be praised. Now you will give your lives to avenge this outrage.
Or we could just kill the other guys. Yeah!
The moo cow from the welfare office. Sorry, we're closed.
Bitch!
What was that?
Oh. I thought we had a flat, but we just ran over some girl. Whew, thank God. Got a body on Maple.
Tag 22, please repeat your location.
Maple, like the syrup.
Oh, this is fucking fantastic. Oh my God, these kids are heavy. Okay, all right. Gary! Wait, just wait, wait. Oh yeah, okay. Bullet Gary, make me a star.
This is Gail Ravenson reporting live from Little Germany Theme Park on what will forevermore be known as the place where the laughter died. Celebrity icon Vern Troyer is currently missing or presumed dead. The coward responsible for this massacre has been described as a rodent-like man with red hair and wearing a peace t-shirt. Back to you, Bob. Oh, that's right. You're dead. These kids are starting to smell.
Yo, I can't believe I took this fucking job. Fucking bullshit. God damn it. Is this out? Definitely him.
We need to get him inside immediately, along with the merchandise!
Jesus, pity fuck, they're already here.
Now what do we do? Oh, no. That was the safest place in all of paradise.
You guys don't have like a bomb shelter, a basement, or something that the Taliban couldn't have found themselves, right?
No, we don't.
We do.
What?
We do. There's a massive underground shelter beneath the main compound. It's perfect.
You don't want to be perfect? Like, foot up your ass. Who the fuck are you people?
What the fuck did you bring him for?
You'll see, Uncle Dave.
Do you think we can sneak him past the Taliban without them finding out?
And where the fuck are you gonna hide my crotchy dolls?
In plain sight.
Somebody grab the little guy. Come on, little guy.
What the fuck's going on?
Come on. Okay, come on.
Citizens of this great nation, town, be on the lookout for this psychopath, deranged killer, also known as
Postal Dude.
Postal Dude. That's the best we could come up. Postal Dude. He's wanted in conjunction with the kidnapping, the shooting at the welfare office, the assassination of candidate Wells,
and killing a Chinese woman.
Killed a poor, innocent Chinese lady. So if you see him...
You ever just have one of those days?
No.
Hey, the Postal Dude! Hey, come on!
I don't think that's him. See how his hair flows, though? This guy looks more like Jesus.
Shit. Hey, let's go.
Thank you.
Come on. Hey, which way do you go? This way.
Why did you help him?
Want to clean the windows again?
Yeah, fuck.
against the wall, now! Ow.
Huh? Look like I bagged me the postal, dude.
God damn! You son of a bitch! I think you busted my nose! Ugh, fuck! You fucking asshole! I'm gonna fuck you up!
Sorry.
Cops, Krabby, this weighs a freaking ton.
Come here.
Handcuffs, those are cool. Is that a flashlight? Yeah, pepper spray. Pepper spray.
Officer! Paul Lipscomb, Neighborhood Watchdog Group, Chapter 232.
Good job, citizen.
You see the postal dude?
Yes, yes. He went down that way.
Right. Citizens United, let's get this fucker!
Get him!
Nice outfit. Like you couldn't be more of an ass already.
You look like a penguin. So I dropped the truck off. Now, where is that underground shelter place?
Shh. Go through the bedroom.
Yeah, okay. All right, I'm going in.
All right,
I'm going in. Stay.
Have you heard from Osama?
No.
You know what the fuck?
No.
Have you seen the dog?
No.
Do you know anything?
I don't know.
You are stupid. Stupid.
I'm sorry.
Stupid. Dead.
Why the World Trade Center victims deserve to die after the break.
Discouraged by the inability to stem the spread, which prevents the continent from having any further contact with the rest of the planet. According to leading experts, video games are the number one cause of violence.
Opening it.
My pleasure.
Jenny, you too, huh? Am I the only fucking person who didn't know there was a bomb shelter underneath my bedroom?
It's not a bomb shelter, Uncle Dave.
I can't believe this fucking street.
It's a God shelter.
Gee, what the fuck is this?
This is amazing.
This is a shithole.
What is all this for?
Dave's Bible, chapter 11, Psalm 23. And in the end, the fire and the plagues will come at the behest of the Lord, and the sores, and the boils, and the intestinal ulcers and testicular tumors shall befall all of humanity.
Except for those who hide like rabbits below the ground.
Man, this is pretty sweet. You ever fire?
Don't touch anything! Ah! We will need every bullet for the end of all things.
That's great, Richie, but right now we've got a problem. All right? My house is full of a bunch of fucking religious fanatics that think they're gonna be the chosen people at the end of the world.
As opposed to...
Shut the fuck up.
Won't you shut the fuck up?
You don't think I'll come over there? I'll come with a fucking...
I'll stick this finger up your ass.
Yeah, you and what fucking ladder?
I'll get you.
I'll fucking...
Take the... God damn.
Richie, the point is... We don't need to be worried about the end right now, okay? We just need to take those guns, go upstairs, kill some motherfuckers, get my merchandise back, sell it so we can pay off the IRS, all right?
Not gonna sell the merchandise, Uncle Dave!
What?
I am sorry to inform you, but that was never part of the plan!
So what is the plan?
To end the world.
You guys have issues, man.
Did you know about this?
No, I didn't fucking know about this.
It works for you.
Apparently not.
I can hear you.
Richie.
Now it is time for the rest of you to know the full extent of our plan. This is why we need the crotchy dolls.
What happens up my ass stays up my ass.
The avian bird flu, the plague for which the Western devil has no cure. If these dolls are to be distributed throughout the United States, there will be death and destruction beyond all comprehension. Yeah! That is what I'm talking about.
So, to make a long story short, the Taliban wanted to get hold of the flu and spread it.
Well, whatever. I mean, we stopped them, right? We're good.
Exactly. We stopped them so that we could do it our own way.
What?
See? They only wanted to spread it in the United States.
But in order to fulfill the prophecy in Dave's Bible, we must wipe out the entire planet.
He's fucking nuts.
Which brings us to you, Mr. Van Troyer.
If he wrote anything about me in that Bible, we're gonna have some serious problems.
And you shall know when the final day of reckoning begins, because on that day, a tiny entertainer will be raped by 1,000 monkeys.
That's it. I'm gonna kick your fucking ass.
I'm sorry, little dude.
Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh! Enough! 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 Stop it! We must do as God commands!
Bring on the monkeys!
Oh, not the monkeys.
Where'd you get so many monkeys?
I don't fucking know. I got nothing to do with this shit.
Oh, shit.
All in all, this has really not been a very pleasant day. Yeah, but...
Unfortunately, the desperate nature of our situation suggests that we may need another of us to embrace martyrdom as we bring our fight to the infidels. Now.
Hey, how about Abdul?
Let's go do some drugs.
Oh, that is a great idea. A great idea. Genius. Of course, one must agree willingly. Now, Abdul, if you don't want to be blown into a tiny million pieces, raise your hand, hop on one foot, and sing Freebird. Abdul it is. Now, if we just had Osama. Does anybody know where the fuck he is?
So you can see that just by changing the words you use, you can motivate your employees in all new ways. If you master my 117 steps to dominating your employees, I personally guarantee you will have a team of little killer bees ready to live or die at your command. You can make them work for 72 hours straight at a time, especially if you put crystal meth in the water. Now, some of you may be asking, isn't crystal meth illegal? Technically, yes. But the U.S. Air Force uses it to fuel their pilots when they're on night missions over Afghanistan. So it can't be that illegal if the U.S. Air Force uses it.
Who's
Oh?
What now?
So you just gonna shoot us?
Yeah. You know, I'm really sorry, man. I mean, obviously this is some sort of misunderstanding, but you can see where I kind of have to go with it at this point. Hmm? I mean, you're my nephew, but these are my people. Gotta lead them to the promised land.
You're a douche.
Not?
Yeah. Actually, the Bible doesn't say to kill you.
What the fuck, Richie? Come on, I'm God on Earth, remember? Read your fucking Bible.
When you read between the lines, it's remarkable how the meanings change. Now, the way I read it was God chose you as a pawn to get this movement going.
But now it's time for someone else to take charge. Someone who truly believes.
Not Richie. Myself for who I am. I'm a fucking chubby chaser too. Fuck it, man. This is great. Oh, you know what? Today is the start of my whole new life. Hey.
Because I am the only guy who knows where the truck filled with bird flu is parked.
Yeah, that's clever. That is clever. But it's not insurmountable. You didn't go far. We'll just find it ourselves and then we'll kill you.
Or not.
Member, Bible said that you didn't have to kill me. And you said you weren't going to. And you killed Dave.
Yeah. But as soon as I said that, this was a lousy idea. So we'll be right back. Get in here!
Thank you.
What are you still doing here?
We're supposed to wait for Richard to get back with the truck. And then we eat the poison brownies and ascend into Godhead. Star couldn't wait. She was on a cleanse.
Yeah, that all sounds like a real good plan. Me? Let me go upstairs, kill me some terrorists. Probably die in a hail of bullets. If by some miracle I make it out alive, I'm gonna find that fat fuck of yours, Richard. I'm gonna stick this machine gun up his self-righteous ass. Yeah. Decisions, decisions.
You cunning little bitch. You're not retarded, are you? You've just been faking it. Mine.
They'll meet us later.
All right, ladies, this is where we split up. Go home to your families. Think for yourselves. And no more crazy cults that look forward to the end of the world.
Don't worry, we decided to be Christians from now on.
Well. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on. Hold on.
Why? Because you're married?
No. I just want to give Karen a turn.
Oh. Okay.
Hi.
Oh, my God.
Paradise. Here I come.
Speaking of wild shit, have you seen that guy's wife?
Yeah, she's hard to miss.
She's a good fuck, though.
You fucked her?
Several times. She's got a clapper in her trailer. The lights go on and off and on and off. Makes you feel like a rock star.
Let's go to the trailer.
It's the postal dude! Get him!
Thank you.
so hot.
And you turned into a crazy psychopath.
There were some pretty good reasons.
It's what the hell say.
I have to destroy a postal truck filled with lethal microbes before a doomsday cult or a terrorist group gets their hands on it and destroys the entire world.
Yeah, like I believe that.
Jihad! Clap! Huh? Jihad!
Okay, where's that truck?
Great. Okay. No. Oh. I'm sorry, Mr. Laden. Looks like your credit card's been declined.
What?
It looks like every free government on the planet has frozen your assets.
Would you take a check?
Cash.
American.
I'm a little short.
Sammy, we need you right away.
Do you have any cash?
No. Run!
Freaking Arabs.
Go back to Mecca and run around your big black box.
Fuck. Okay. Yeah, you ever get like a hangnail? What the hell was that?
Fuckhead Greg. Yeah, come on. Fuckhead Greg.
How's that? Huh?
Yeah. I'm gonna see the left, motherfucker.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. You're right.
My soon-to-be ex-wife.
Oh. Yeah. You like that?
Yeah. You did a great job. A little faster.
That ought to do it.
Good. Here, champ. Come on, buddy. Champ? Come on.
Poop. Let's get out of here.
Our energies by cutting out his sleeve!
Okay. Fuck this.
Bomb that can take out a whole city block bomb. Do I have your attention?
Get down here! What
is wrong with you people? You're so busy trying to blow up the world in the name of God. Newsflash, fucktards. God doesn't need your help. He's God. And he, she, it, they gave you life. And you're wasting it. Look around you. Look. Look, God damn it. See? We're not that different. Because we all come from the same family, known as humanity. And what do families do? Do they fight? Yeah, sure. But they work it out. Because they love each other. And they know that they're stuck with each other, just like all of us are. Here, on this crazy big mud ball called Earth. So come on, people. Let's try and find some common ground, huh?
Well, we all hate Jews.
Well, everybody knows that.
No, not a hate thing. A happy thing. I think it's time to empty our hands of guns so we can fill our hands with hugs. If you want to waste this precious gift we call life, I can't stop you. So go ahead. Shoot. Or hug.
Shoot him.
No, you motherfucker. God damn.
Ready, I'm still wet, though.
Just plug that little thing in. I'll be there in 1 second.
Save some virgins for me.
Please insert an additional 25 cents to complete your long distance call.
Hello, this is George W. Bush.
It's Osama. I need some help, man.
Hi there, Osama. How are you?
You gotta speak up, George. I can't hear you over the gunfire. Gunfire. I'm trapped in a trailer park in Paradise City.
I'm here for you, buddy. We got you on satellite. Should have sent a couple cruise missiles down there.
No.
Please insert an additional 25 seconds to continue your long continue your long call.
I was thinking maybe a helicopter to come pick me up.
Hey, that could work. There's a field just south of you. I'll pick you up there.
Oh, thanks, Georgie.
Yeah.
I just wish I knew how to quit you.
Internal Revenue Service, Frank Dumont. We're here to conduct an audit on a Mr. David Clark.
You are American government?
Yes, sir. Is Mr. Clark at home?
Hold on one moment, government man. I have someone to speak to you.
Unauthorized fruit sales.
Should have brought that dip.
Abdul! Abdul, where is your belt? You're not wearing your explosive belt!
We're taking the cop car.
Abdul!
Lorraine, stop licking your own asshole, okay? You're my publisher. You tell them that this is a prime example of why everybody should buy my book, How to Fire an Employee Without Making Him Go Postal, because I'm a fucking...
announcement from the president.
This is the president of the United States of America. CIA intelligence has confirmed that the governments of China and India were directly responsible for the terrorist cell recently uncovered in Paradise. Worse still, they continue to make t-shirts for well under a dollar. In response, we've been forced to destroy both countries with nuclear force. China, despite all our freedom-loving efforts, was able to send 30 atomic warheads our way. They should hit in a little under 2 minutes. I wish you all the best of luck with your future endeavors, and God bless America.
Well?
I regret nothing.
Yo, I forget the stuff. What are you doing? Don't you normally get out of here? Come on, let's go. Come on. Let's go out.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Georgie.
I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
Flowers all around. From the birth of Mother Earth, we hear the magic sound singing. Was cast into the sea, ripples without love, ripple to a tidal wave, swelling to a flood. Brave the storm, your lonesome ships, courage, it's not far. Sail away, we'll find a day, the land of la la la, singing.
Purchase of one clone, get a second clone!